is an old deer.
This real tree on, people's gonna think there's a ghost in this brush pile. They can just hear me talking, they can't even see me.
Can't even see you. Mossy oak, baby. Mossy oak.
And we're gonna hammer some bird thunder chicken, baby. Brother Stan put a shot on a hog. We're gonna let him sit for just a little bit.
Oklahoma Frog Mafia.
Wild for the Outdoors, check it out.
Check us out on YouTube.
You do.
Wild for the Outdoors.
Twitter. Facebook.
We got a Twitter?
We got a Twitter.
I didn't know we had a Twitter.
We got a Twitter.
Hello there, and welcome to Season 2 Wild for the Outdoors TV. And this week, we're going to be taking you to a couple years back, whitetail deer season on some new property. Now, I want to kind of go into this a little bit, telling you what's going on here, because I think it'll help you be more successful out in the woods. The landowner said, okay, this is the piece of property. I'll take you over and show it to you. Hey, that's great. So we head into this piece of property, and there's only one entrance. Yeah, there's a road that runs to the outside edge of it, but it's so steep. It's crazy. I mean, it's up and down, up and just steep hills. So the only way to get in is right next to a house. Okay, whatever, you know. We pull in there, we park, and there's one road cut right down the top of the ridge, all the way to the bottom. Lots of sign everywhere, rub. Right next to the house. Rub, tracks. And of course, what we do, we walk right down that road, and he shows me everything about it. And I thought, and I know other people's hunting this property, I thought, I wonder if that's how it happens every time. Do they always just come to this spot and then walk right down this road? So I didn't want to do that. I thought, you know, I kind of was looking at this rub and the trails, and right behind this house, right behind their property, was a ridge, and it shot straight out behind his house. And I thought, that's where I'm going to go. Opening day, that's where I'm going to go. I didn't even, you know, scout it. I just kind of thought, you know, if everybody else comes here and walks down this road, I'm not doing that. I'm going to do something different. And that's where we pick up this first video here, first part of the show, is opening morning. No, wait, talking about opening evening. I didn't get to make it that morning. And trust me, that's, for a deer hunter, that's pretty crazy. You really want to be there open in the morning. Goose trying to steal the show back here. So anyway, I just went in to this other spot. You know, it wasn't even an access, it was just another ridge. There was this ridge where everybody walks in at, and this ridge. I walk in there and come to a big white oak tree, and of course I'm checking it out, plumb full of acorns underneath it. So I move on. I don't want to be there. If there's acorns underneath there, it means nothing's eating it. I go to the about 60 or 70 yards, probably 60 yards in, find another white oak, a big, you know, big good white oak dropping acorns. All I find are caps, you know, just the little caps on top, and a little bit of deer poop. Hey, I find me a spot just right on a log. I got some new camo, you know, the quick camo, Gila suit, whatever you want to call it, 3D camo, and I just sit there on a log. And it wasn't 30 minutes when this nice buck walks right to me. You know, I'm thinking, oh man, I got to get all this, you know, I'm self-filming, I got to get the camera on and all that. So that's where we pick up this video. The buck is 18 yards in front of me, behind a tree, making a scrape and playing peekaboo. Check it out.
blew that. That was my fault. They're feeding under these white oaks right here. Which is kind of why I sit here. Because of the white oaks. Yards from where I was at, and it still found me.
Matt.
I was on my way out, and just seen a doe, big old doe, and shot a tree. Awesome. Well, it's still raining. I was walking up to the truck and walked up on a doe. She was walking right towards me, and I had about that much area to shoot right in her chest or hit a tree on either side. Hit a tree. T-Mac 0, deer 2 this year so far. But anyway, I'm gonna put on my quick camo and do a little stalking. I know where that buck was headed, so I'm gonna go after him.
Now this next little bit of footage here, man, I tell you what, it's the biggest whitetail deer I've ever filmed. And at 50 yards, I was sure wishing I shot a mechanical bow at the time. Of course, all I got is my Mike Parker longbow, you know, and I've already missed once this year. There's no way I'm taking a shot at 50 yards. Not even with a mechanical bow, I wouldn't have taken that shot. A compound bow, whatever you want to call it. But this buck, I guarantee you, is probably, if I ever see a buck that big again, I hope I do, but he was a monster, free-range whitetail. There's people hunting just up the draw. There's people hunting just down the draw. And, you know, this buck has made it that many years, and to get that close to him and film him was awesome. I tell you what, I sure was glad I had my scent barrier there. That sock I hung up right next to me. You know, whenever I go in the woods, I carry scent now. Used to, I didn't. But that buck smelled something. But it spooked him for just a second, and then he calmed down and walked right on by at, you know, 50 yards. But when I'm hunting, especially on the ground, I hang up, that's just a sock, whatever you want. I've used camouflage, do-rags, whatever it is. I'll take and spray that with some scent. Of course, I've got my cover scent on, my deer dander, always. And, you know, that rag, I had some, you know, white doe in heat. And then I also had sprayed out some white oak acorn. Just a little bit, you know, just a little bit of scent there to kind of put out a buffer between me and anything else. And it worked. You know, if I'd have been a little closer, I'd had all the time in the world to shoot that deer. Even after it spooked, it came back by and walked on by. So, hey, I'm a firm believer in scents, and I'm a firm believer in, you know, the scents that I use. The next footage, the last bit of footage here is the rifle season. I got some great footage of a couple nice bucks, and all this happened on the same ridge. That one ridge, I hunted from the top all the way to the bottom and had just encounter after encounter with bucks. And that one, you know, this one buck, he's a good one. I mean, he there's nothing wrong with him at all. But I just kind of had my sights set on Mr. Big Daddy. And I ended up only killing one deer that year, and it was a doe. And I didn't film it. So, next footage, just a little rifle hunting footage just to show you what kind of pressure I'm talking about and what's going on here. You can hear shots in the distance, you know, shots up close. This is high pressure whitetail deer hunting, man.
They reach the sky. Smoke fills this holler from steels hid nearby. Downhill Billy Highway, crossroads nobody knows. Down past the byway near the river we grow smoke. And there's sweat stains on the collar. Across the water between your world and mine. Long way is the distance, but we're all doing time. And there's sweat stains on the collar. We'll be right back.
Since I've seen them two bucks, I've heard five shots in the last 5 minutes. They're starting to move. I'm gonna tell you why I'm hunting right here. I wanted to go on further back in, but it was so quiet this morning, I didn't want to spook anything down in there. So I hunted up here where I was bow hunting at the beginning of the year. And the reason them bucks are in here, because there's a little, these ridges, they're steep, but there's little flat areas as they go down. It's steep, then it flattens out, steep, then it flattens out. And them deer run on them flats. They're not flat, but you know what I mean. There's one right here. Then it drops off and there's another one. Well, I wanted to get down to that other one, but it was just too quiet this morning. But we had a good morning anyway. Saw some bucks. I'm happy. Those deer were 20 and 30 yards because this is a bow hunting spot. You know, I'm packing a 308. So this evening I want to get further down in. But I'm going to take my climber top with me so I can wrap it around a tree and sit comfortably. Because, man, if you want to stay a long time, you got to be comfortable. And the longer you stay, the better off your chances are of getting a good buck.
For all kinds of outdoor stuff, cooking, hunting, gardening, go check out our website, www.wildforthoutdoors.com. You can contact me there, and it takes you to our YouTube channel where you can subscribe and just have access to hundreds upon hundreds of our videos. Well, that's our show today. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm looking forward to bringing you guys another one next week. So stick around, stay tuned, keep watching. God bless, love y'all, and I'll see you next time.